with in regards to Coke cans. You know, you can chop the bottoms off to make penny stoves. Now, what I'm going to do is kind of make the penny stove idea, but without holes in.
Show this one as well, though.
And then, yeah, put it down there, Lola.
I'm going to show it.
Don't squash it. But I've painted the...
And blow it.
Just, oh, Daddy's recording.
Look, I'm doing a video, just chill your beans.
Daddy's doing
just give me that one back. Right. We've painted them.
With my nail polish.
With nail varnish. To stand out. Now, I mean, that's going to stand out in the woods. So what I'm thinking is, we put a nail in the middle. And then we can pin it to whatever in the trees.
Love it.
Maybe stick a bit of like a plant of wood or a dead branch or something in the trees and stick them on it, like almost like a HFT course. But yeah, it's just a test. We're going to see what it's like when they're dry. And,
no, I'm
yeah,
doing
we'll give it a go.
Oh,
that was a pretty nifty idea.
Like,
okay, so this is the finished product.
It's basically
a penny stove, but without the holes. Taped up the thing just to cover the edges so it's not sharp. And I'm thinking, I said if we pin that or even just rest that somewhere in the woods, it gives you a nice large target to aim at. I mean, you could alternatively put a different colour in the middle as a smaller target.
Yeah,
but yeah, just for the time being, it'll be good for me and Tiz to get out and practice. Gonna make up that though. See if I can get 7 or 8 of them and make a mini HFT course in the woods. I'm gonna give it a couple of coats of yellow right in the centre. Have a sort of a distinct colour difference and a better aiming point or scoring point, whatever.